If you're working on a book or a document in pages, you may want to create more interesting loot at the beginning of your chapter or section, and you can easily do that with drop cases. So I have a document here and I want to create a drop case for this paragraph. I can select the letter, and then you want to make sure you click on format at the very top of your ribbon, and then you will have more menu. So now you have a formatting menu. You want to make sure you have a style selected, and then you scroll down to the very bottom. If I click on drop cap, I will automatically have the default style applied to my letter. So you have a lot of options actually with this drop case. I'm going to actually do the guides because I want to show you that you have a lot of options how you align your cases and so on. So now you can see how everything looks. So I'm going to still select my drop case, my letter. Now the options here are you can click on that A by that kind of text, and you have some 6 different ways of formatting your drop case, and I can click on each of them to test it out. And so you see you can make a bigger letter, smaller, bolder, and also the alignment changes. You can see some of them can be sticking out, outdenting a bit. You can also put it like in a shape and so on. So you can select which one you like. I'm just going to go with the first one. Now I can still change the text color. So if I go to text color, I'm going to change it to blue like that. And I can also specify how big the drop case is. If I select more lines, the lines option gives you how big it is. You can make it giant or you can make it 2 lines. You can't do less than 2 because it's not going to be a drop case. Now let's say I'm going to do 3. I like to have it 3 lines. Now I can also specify more than 1 character. So the drop case doesn't have to be just the first letter. It can be actually the first word. So I can have a first word like that. But I just like the letter, so I'll leave it that as well. Now if you click options, you have even more opportunity to format it differently to make it more unique. I can make it raised lines. That means you see my alignment for my letter is at top, but my text starts in the middle of the line, and I can make it at the very bottom. So it starts at the bottom of the drop case. Now I can also have the text either wrap around the letter or have it more justified, so you can see that the text is right there like that, versus if I change this option to wrapped, you can see you don't see it that much with this option, but it's wrapped more around the letter. You can also add more spacing, so I can move the text a little bit more to the right away from my drop case, or just have it close. Now I can also move the drop case to the left of my margins, so all the text will be over there, but I can have even on the side completely separate. So I'm going to go back, have it aligned perfectly. Now I can also put a background to the letter. And here you can also do a border. And also, let's say if it's a word, you can spell it in that shape. And I can change it. Let's say, let me make it yellow so you can see it more like that. And you can make it like a circle. You can make it oval. You can make a square. So you can change the radius as well of your shape. And I'm going to remove it. That's a little bit too much, like too much, trying too hard, right? And so these are the options basically for your drop case. And another thing that you have also control of is if you click on layout, you can also specify that the drop case would be indented, let's say a few spaces this way. So you're not only outdenting it to the left, you can also move it to the right with the use of the indents. So here are some 3 examples that you can do in pages to create interesting drop cases. So thanks so much for watching.